Today, the yin and the yang of pheasant hunting. South Dakota treats us to a perfect fall hunt. Piles of birds and the best dogs to match. But then, like they say, payback is a blizzard.
Rooster Tales, presented by Pheasants Forever.
Welcome to the show. When you mix a picture-perfect South Dakota setting with some of bird hunting's best dogs and a pile of roosters, you come up with a place called Daybreak. Bill Shirk has a story.
All right, guys.
A plate of eggs and a mug of hot Joe. Pretty hard to beat at Daybreak. But if you look out the window, breakfast gets trumped. And clearly, a story is about to unfold. It's the story of Daybreak, South Dakota's quiet place until right now. Rooster.
Traditional South Dakota, you think of a great big cornfield or a big section of CRP that's just flat. We have a lot of the river bottom.
Oh, look at the deer.
It's kind of scrubby, brushy kind of stuff. And we're kind of tucked down in along a river and there's a lot of trees. It wasn't at all what I expected for South Dakota hunting.
Jacob Gibbs showed up on this hunt. He shoots outdoor still photography.
We're documenting the trip for Pheasants Forever. They'll be using that photography in some of their upcoming issues.
And over there, two brothers, Todd Dana and Eric Mathiewicz.
I feel like I should have one already.
Both first timers to Daybreak.
I don't know what happened there. I hit it. I saw some feathers come off.
The hunting is off-the-cuff crazy.
Rooster!
If the bird numbers aren't cool enough, Daybreak's real charm comes from, well, we need to rewind back to breakfast to understand.
All right, ready to go. Come on out, let's go.
Morgan Haglund misses most morning meals. See, he's out here working Daybreak's kennels.
Get your eyes cleared out. Yeah, look at you. We have about 13 girls and about 14 boys. Usually a hunt with about 12 dogs.
At sunup, like clockwork, Morgan winds up Daybreak's fleet of dogs.
Up. Up. Okay, guys, let's go.
In my opinion, I'm a little brainwashed, though, because I grew up with them. They're the best all-around gun dog for birds.
Come on, guys.
They hunt very well, and it's neat to watch them.
And they know how to find birds, which creates moments like this.
Bird.
Gotta get the first one.
But the best is still ahead. Hang tight.
Rooster Tales is brought to you by Franke Guns, Mountain Dew, B&W Trailer Hitches, Watson Hunting Camp, and by Star Bank. This segment of Rooster Tales is brought to you by North Dakota Tourism. Start your journey at NorthDakotaLegendary.com.
In the midst of this melee, a man and a camera.
You know, with the camera, I wish I could be here for a week.
Oh,
It is fun watching Jacob. I know he's a little bit torn because he wants to have the shotgun up. You just see him get the blinders on and get focused and start shooting stuff.
I was up early this morning and I saw a big buck right on the ridge. We just crept along slowly up the ridge until I could get in a position where I could get him in the camera frame the way I wanted him, and I ended up with this nice shot of a buck just silhouetted against the orange sky looking at me.
That's a snapshot of life at daybreak.
You can walk out the back door, go hunting, and not see another person all day. All the land is contiguous. We have basically 2 miles wide by 5 miles long.
Rooster!
By evening, everyone's wiped out after an absolutely awesome hunt.
Tucker's in a coma.
Well, except for the ringnecks.
As the sun's going down, and we're watching a couple of roosters up on the ridge.
They're like squared off, fighting together. We're sitting at the campfire, and they're right in front of us, and you get to watch them doing their thing.
So, if you ever visit Daybreak, consider yourself warned. This place is, from sunup to sunset, in a word, epic.
It's awesome. I'm already planning for next year.
Rooster Tales is brought to you by South Dakota Tourism Huron, the Minnesota Horse and Hunt Club, Scent Killer Gold by Wildlife Research Center, Cannon River Ranches, Bonfi, and by Lupient GMC.
Today's topic, we're going to talk about preconditioning your dog for the hunt, different elements that you might be involved during the hunt. For example, there's nothing worse than being invited out on a duck hunt and having your dog retrieving decoys. Don't you think, Tom?
Well, right. You know, and think about anything that you could run into.
Yep.
On that first hunt. You know, here we have a dog in a layout blind. What if you're gonna go out and you're gonna hunt ducks in a field? They have to know how to be in here and stay in here. Decoys, boats, how many dogs have never been in a boat? Opening day happens, it's pitch black. The dog doesn't get in the boat, you throw him in there, he's got a bad experience right to start with.
And he gets back out.
And it just gets worse as the day goes on. So do some prep work ahead of time, think ahead, and it's to the dog's benefit. You're gonna have fun in the dog too.
Absolutely, and it's you're just going to come off better. You're going to be invited back, and it's just common sense, folks. Expose your dog to these different elements as you socialize them throughout all the hunting environment. For more on this and other topics, go to our website.
Welcome back to the show. In a hunting season and a lifetime, no two hunts are equal. We're off to the grasslands in North Dakota to share one hunt that will surely last the test of time.
Way out in rural North Dakota, in the heart of pheasant country, if you look in through the outdoor of the local country cafe, you quickly realize,
yeah, that's a blaze orange bowling pin. You don't see that every day.
Everything around these parts looks best dressed in orange.
Even your retainer is blaze orange. I never thought of that.
For Tim Ettinger, this morning in this place proves to be one of life's great moments.
You think we're gonna get them? What if I miss everyone? Do you think Grandpa's gonna miss everyone?
And no, not because the Arrowhead has the best chow around. See, just out of town, North Dakota's rural country rolls on for literally hundreds of square miles.
Oh, feels good to stretch.
And Tim hunts pheasants here just about every year. It's like his religion. and this season.
Are you ready? Give me knuckles. All right.
He's sharing his spot.
Here, Dad wants you to be all blazed up.
That's Tim's son, Blaze, right there. And that's Tim's dad, his original hunting buddy.
Okay, Dad's gonna get out your gun, and every gun, we treat it as if it's a real gun.
This will be Blaze's first walk-along on a hunt. Does he look excited or what?
You ready? Whee! All right. Are you excited?
Yep.
I'm so glad you're out here with me. Let's go get some birds. We're out here in New England, North Dakota. Blaze, you stay right along this edge. It's just excellent, excellent pheasant habitat. It's a lot of wheat farming, lot of fence rows, ditch ravines, sloughs and draws.
For Tim's dad, this hunt may be more about memories versus the moment. After all,
everybody check safeties. Check your safe. Check your gun. Watch your gun. Check your gun. Watch your gun barrel.
In Tim's actions, Grandpa John sees himself.
It brought back a lot of memories because I can remember 30, 35 years ago teaching Tim the art of hunting.
Come on, bud. Daddy used to hunt with Grandpa John like this when he was a boy. Did you know that?
Blaze, are you going faster than I am? Huh? You say yes, Grandpa, I'm so much younger.
The fact that Tim's dad can be along on this trip at all is a story in itself. Just listen.
Early last spring, about in March, I was diagnosed with cancer of a vocal cord. Yep.
And at first the prognosis wasn't real good, and he just rallied. Unbelievable, tough old German, let me tell you.
Grandpa John started a series of 36 radiation treatments. He drove himself to every appointment.
I got the idea that if Dad could beat this cancer, we would go to North Dakota pheasant hunting this fall.
When Tim asked me, he said, how would you like to go on a trip with pheasants forever? And I said, I think I'd enjoy that.
Sure enough, John's cancer dwindled and dreams of pheasant fields bloomed. So to his word, Tim took his father and son on the hunt of a lifetime.
This is what I settled my mind on, and this is what we've been talking about since February. There are a ton of roosters in there.
Out here, talk quickly turns to birdie action.
Get it to you. Bring it. Good girl. Good girl.
Nice shot, Dad.
There it is. Where is it? There it is. There it is. Bring it here, baby.
All right. Are you glad you went on that walk with me?
Yeah.
Way to go. Let's go. I think this trip for me is truly a circle that is complete. I can't put into words what this trip means. I didn't know if I was going to have another opportunity to hunt with my dad like this. And to be able to do it with my dad and my son, it's absolutely the best hunting trip I've ever had in my life.
Got it. That's the end of it.
Good girl. Good girl. Let me see. There you go, Teely. There we go, Blaze. What do you think of that? When I see him put his hand on Blaze's head and give his head a little rub and tell him that he's proud of him and whatnot, I know that he wouldn't trade this for $1 million.
Who would on a day where birds forever flush and three generations walk a field as one?
Well, Grandpa, was it everything it was cracked up to be?
Yeah.
Rooster Tales is brought to you by Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light Beer. Visit Pier, South Dakota. Brown's Hunting Ranch. Purina. And by Stillwater Motors.
Harsh is the season of South Dakota winter, come cold December days. It's a time when old man winter forces just about everything to grind to a near halt. Well, except for the pheasants.
Look at that. We gotta get going, guys. We gotta get down here.
And this guy. Late season hunts get Bruce Beam all worked up. So much so.
Hey, Dad. Trace out.
He sometimes gets a bit forgetful.
We forgot you, puppy. We forget you.
Yes, out here.
Brewster!
All heck breaks loose near the end of the hunting season.
Brewster!
Brewster!
They got it.
See, the snow gets deeper and the temperatures drop, birds huddle up in the best habitat.
Hand! Brewster!
It all makes Bruce yell.
Brewster, coming at ya!
A lot.
Good shot. It's nice to be out here in January and to shoot this many birds.
But this isn't a story about birds. Instead, about a legacy of a place called Bald Eagle Ranch.
I feel very fortunate to be able to use this while I'm here. And I know that sounds corny, but I really am.
See, years ago, Bruce Beam bought the old South Dakota ranch and hooked up with the good folks at Pheasants Forever.
We had the Pheasants Forever biologist come out from Chamberlain. And I said, you know, what can we do to make this better habitat? And he gave us some ideas. One of the big things, he said, you need to burn this field up or you need to graze it. The more we kind of experimented and researched a little bit, we found out that habitat is really the only way for us to get good quality birds. Over the years, that's what's happened.
The habitat recipe consisted of food sources, nesting cover, and plenty of protection from the cold winter elements. Walk around the ranch a bit, and you can see Bruce's recipe worked.
I guess, you know, the legacy I'd like to have is that we're good stewards of the land, and that there'll always be good wildlife.
In the process, Bruce created something else. Birdie paradise for all his buddies.
We have a lot of fun together.
See, just about every weekend during the hunting season, friends take over the old ranch house.
Never seen pheasant breasts like that before.
For me, it's kind of my fortress of solitude. I mean, I end up being the camp cook and bottle washer and what have you, but it's fun.
Out here, the old South Dakota cliche certainly comes true. If you don't like the weather, just wait a bit.
Well, it's a bit cold and snowy, but hopefully we'll get a few birds.
Today we're having a blizzard. You know, I mean, what are you gonna do about it?
Next morning, the weather takes a serious turn. Out in the blizzard, something you might not expect to see.
It's why I live in Minnesota when I've had an opportunity to live pretty much all over the United States.
That 79-year-old standing there, that's Bruce's father.
But the change of seasons, this is exciting to me when it gets this way.
Yep, he's still tough as nails.
I don't think you'll see me spending the whole day out here. Well, I can hear them. They must be getting closer.
And over there, through the snow, this guy, that's Bruce's son.
It's nice to come out and spend time with my family, get to spend some time with my grandpa and my cousins. As things get more busy, it's nice to just have a few days. You guys are stuck somewhere and just each other.
I mean, how fortunate am I to experience those things with my father and my son? And like I say, you know, it continues, you know? So I'm very fortunate.
Three generations fight snow and cold along with a crew of friends. Together, they create one of the most memorable hunts we've ever seen.
Coming at ya! He's down.
Hand, hand, Brewster.
Release, release. Good girl.
They're pretty, aren't they? They're just beautiful.
They sure are. And they may just prove the birdie dreams do come true out on the South Dakota prairie.
This is about as good as it gets.
There's just something about blowing snow and cold that builds character and leaves a lasting memory. Well, it's that time. We've come to the end of the field. Remember, this land is a gift that we all get to enjoy. Take the time to introduce somebody new to the field. Good luck hunting.